It's Rich here from the RCNetwork.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at the build review for my Traxxas TRX4 chassis kit. So as you see here, I have the entire chassis kit all assembled, and in this video we're going to be going over quite a lot of information, so definitely pay attention throughout this video. Now, one of the first things that we're going to be going over is the manual. We're going to talk about the tools needed to actually assemble this vehicle, any extra items that I came across that I needed to get a perfect install and build of this kit, any upgrades that I installed for this TRX4, and of course how the build went overall, any issues I came through, tough parts of the manual, and finally in this video we'll be going over some of the future plans for this chassis kit and where I'll be taking this great scale truck. If you haven't already done so, please check out my full unboxing video of the Traxxas TRX4 chassis kit. I go over everything that's included inside the kit and what you would expect once receiving your kit and opening it up. The manual that came with the TRX4 chassis kit is quite detailed. You have color graphics throughout this manual and lots of great information. Now, I urge you, please read this manual prior to actually attempting the build. There's lots of good information that you may not notice if you just dive in and start building this thing. They have lots of good information throughout the manual that'll definitely help you with your build of your TRX4 kit. A couple of things to point out throughout the manual is they do give you this cool little guide down here of measuring out screws. Yes, you can actually measure the screw right down here. You don't have to grab calipers or anything else. They provide that on every page of the manual. Now, they do give one-to-one diagrams here over on the side. So as you're opening up bags, you definitely have all the parts in every bag. I had no missing parts throughout this kit. And what's nice, you can just kind of drop it on here and match up the exact size, especially when you're looking at some of the bearings, the screws, the set pins, and that type of stuff, some of the technical stuff. Now, over here on the side, they do give you some nice little illustrations of how to do things. You have a check mark and obviously two X's right here on how to seat the bearings into the transmission. Now, typically when I do a build review and cover the manual, I highlight things that I found that were maybe either confusing or maybe were incorrect. And throughout this entire manual, I did not use my highlighter once. This thing is very well illustrated. It goes over all of the tough and tricky parts, especially when dealing with some of the small servos throughout the build, and everything was very well detailed. Now, one thing that I was a little bit nervous about, even in my expert building experience, was setting up some of the smaller servos for the two-speed and also the locking front and rear differentials. These things were all labeled, everything was very well laid out, and it explained how to do everything, and it was a snap to get everything done and finished on this TRX4 chassis kit. Now, one recommendation that I would have, and I ended up having to kind of redo this step, was once I had all of the servo and ESC wires all routed throughout the chassis here, I didn't quite know which one was which, and I tried to trace them, but there's so many of them, I had to kind of redo this step. So I advise you, and kind of what I did was I used just simple painter's tape and labeled each end of the servo wires with exactly what it was. That way, when you go to plug everything in into the receiver right here, you know exactly which one it is. And please be advised, there are two channel ones, so don't assume that the second plug is for the throttle. It's definitely not, so be aware of that situation as well. One thing to note about the shock setup is they do offer a 5mm, 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 and 9mm for the left front shock. So be advised when you're setting up your ride height, that will dictate, I believe, something that has to do with the front steering geometry, just to keep everything all working good on this TRX4 platform. And rest assured, even when you complete the build, they do have a quick start guide here towards the end to get you all set up with your electronics, including the radio system, getting everything set up with the XL5HV ESC, and finally getting everything running correctly with the shifting and also the locking front and rear differentials. The primary tools to build your TRX4 chassis kit is a 2.5, 2.0, and 1.5 millimeter hex driver and a 7.0 nut driver to put on the wheel nuts. Some supplemental tools that definitely help with the build but are not needed are some needle nose pliers, some shock shaft pliers, cover that a little bit later, and a good sharp hobby knife for just trimming up some of the plastics. Everything came off of trees, but there was a couple of little spots where I just felt that needed a little trimming. In the TRX4 kit, you get plenty of black grease for all the different places that needs black grease, and you get also a bottle of silicone shock oil. Now, I do wish the Traxxas would actually label the shock oil with what viscosity it is. So if you felt that you needed more dampening or less dampening, you can actually go up or down in weight of oil. But that's for another chapter. Now, a couple of things that I do recommend for the build is some thread lock. There's a couple spots in the build that you will need a little bit of thread lock, but also if you install upgrades in the future, you'll definitely need that if any of your upgrades include aluminum or even brass. Now, no tire glue is included in the kit. You will need that. It's just basically a CA glue, but tire glue is definitely preferred to glue the tires to the rims. And finally, some Protec RC Premier Blue O-ring grease. This stuff is pretty cool for building stictionless shocks. Now, I did end up pulling the shocks apart with some shock shaft pliers that I showed earlier, and that allowed me to apply some O-ring grease there just to get the shocks working perfectly. One of the upgrades I installed immediately when building my TRX4 kit was I chose to pick up this stainless steel hardware kit. Now, what's so nice about this, of course, it comes in this nice little case here, but every single screw and nut and bolt is included in this kit for the TRX4 platform, including some of the stainless steel parts for their upgrades, which is pretty cool. So pretty much every screw on this thing now is stainless steel, and it'll prevent any type of rusting and that type of stuff down the road if you plan to get this thing wet. Now, building the TRX4 chassis kit is pretty easy, especially if you follow the directions. Now, in this build, I didn't find any issues at all. And I've got to say, they did a great job of a very complicated kit here. This thing has literally four servos, all the electronic is included in the kit, and you do have to build everything. There's nothing that's really pre-assembled aside from the shocks, so you definitely have to do a lot of assembly to get this thing looking the way it does here. Now, I do admire Traxxas for actually doing a very good owner's manual. That is 90% of the battle with a lot of the products on the market today, is having a good owner's manual, and I think Traxxas hit that one out of the park. Speaking of upgrades, I went with some pretty good stuff for the axles. That's where a lot of abuse happens on these rigs. And I decided to definitely beef up those axles with all of the Traxxas goodies that are available for the axles. On the front axle, as I have it flipped upside down here, I did go with Traxxas's caster block, their inner and outer portal box, and of course the 12 millimeter hex is also aluminum, which is one of their upgrades. Now, I did opt for their heavier duty chromoly universals for the drive shafts inside of the axles here. They provide a little bit more strength than the stock ones. And if you remember this stainless steel hardware kit, all of the upgrades were included in that kit as far as the hardware. So all of these stainless steel screws were included in that stock kit, which is pretty nice because it allowed me to put some fresh, nice screws in there. So if you are upgrading, you have that benefit with the stainless steel screw package. Now, with that, you do have to have plenty of Loctite on hand, and every screw does need Loctite because you're going metal to metal with all the screws now. On the rear, it was much of the same with the inner hub and, once again, the inner and outer portal case. So everything here is nice and beefy, and once again, those chromoly axles are inside of this axle housing. Now, you may have noticed a slightly different servo when I was showing the rig earlier. Now, that is Traxxas's High Torque 400 servo. I have a separate unboxing of that servo, and I'll link that down in the video description if you want to check that out for yourself. Now, this thing packs a whopping 400 ounce inches of torque, which is going to be plenty of power now for this TRX4. Now, I will be installing a BEC a little bit later on down this build series just to give me some peace of mind with the included XL5HV ESC. Some other notables that I installed as far as upgrades on my TRX4 is I installed an aluminum servo horn directly from Traxxas, as well as the aluminum motor mount. These items give me a little bit more peace of mind when I'm out there on the trail. Now, although this chassis seems very busy with all of the different servos here, and of course the electronics that are included and all the wires that you see through, It is very well laid out in the owner's manual. Now, one thing I got to compliment Traxxas on is the implementation of these wheel wells. Now, I've got to say, I wasn't a big fan of these because I'm not really a big scale guy. I'm more of a performance guy. And the way that they've incorporated the wheel wells to give you that scale look that goes all the way into the lower rockers right here and the rock guards and everything else, it just makes so much sense. Everything clicks in when you bolt it on. It all goes into the chassis rails. It's just one finely engineered piece of machinery here that I got the opportunity to build. So that was pretty cool. So what are my future plans for this TRX4? I plan to use the TRX4 Sport camper body. Now, I've got to say, once again, the engineering of Traxxas is amazing because literally this body came right out of the bag and set right onto the kit. There was no adjustment that had to be made, no body holes. They didn't have to trim anything. It just literally sat right on there. I adjusted the front and rear body mounts and it dropped right on, which is pretty nice. It even dropped right into the rock sliders right here. It's a perfect fitting body for this TRX4 kit. Other things that you'll be seeing down the line is the installation of the BEC kit. Can't wait to get this thing installed as well. This is going to keep everything running correctly with that super high voltage servo that I installed. That is the 400 servo from Traxxas. This is going to keep everything happy with all the electronics, no glitching and that kind of stuff from the servo usage. Also, I picked up the front and rear light buckets and LED light kit for the TRX4 Sport, an additional light bar for the front of this vehicle. And of course, you may have noticed I didn't install the Rock Light covers because I picked up the Rock Light kit. Well, guys, that is a quick look at my TRX4 chassis kit. I can't wait to get some paint on this body and get those lights installed and really give this thing a whirl. It's been a blast building this thing, and I got to appreciate all the engineering that went into this TRX4, including the portal axles and all the included electronics. It is just a fine piece of machinery. I can't wait to drive it. Well, guys, that is it for now. If you have any comments or questions about this vehicle or any of the products that I listed in this video, I'll have links to each one of those down in the video description so you can check it out for yourself. As always, comments and questions down below, thumbs up and subscribe. That's it for now, guys. Over and out.